Camp Hill isn't exactly L.A., but it is home to the Showtime Lions. They might not look flashy at first glance, but these kids sure make a good highlight. Lions hosting Columbia in the AA quarterfinals. Third quarter, this is Casey Caruso. Not sure if he has a nickname. I'll just call him the Magician. Some of the best handles you'll see. Lions flashy on defense, too. Here's Zach Kuntz. Base drop. Ridiculous block. And, yeah, he can dunk, too. The Showtime Lions run away with this one. 71-55, the final. More AA. Trinity hosting rival Delone. First quarter, the Squires going on a run. Great mascots in this game. Here's Logan Alexander. Going to put the Squires up three. Shamrocks, though, turn it on in the second. Austin Gilbertson. No lucky Irish here. That's pure skill. Trinity by seven at the half. To the third, Trinity's Jack Butcher with a lesson in getting your feet set. Three's good. Shamrocks on to the semis. 71-61, the final. Sure felt like March outside today, and it looked like March inside the Giant Center. Madness between Carlisle and Reading. One of our best games so far in Quad A. Reading, arguably the best team in the state. Carlisle, unafraid. Fourth quarter, Heard down one. Jordan Purcell, just like Coconut Records, he's going back home to the West Coast. Full court to Ethan Houston. Carlisle takes the lead, but would it hold? Here's Onis Medina. With the finish, we're tied and headed to OT. There's probably another music reference in there. Carlisle hanging for 32 minutes, but in overtime, four-star recruit Lonnie Walker taking over. 37 points and a block to seal it as Carlisle falls 78-73. Top seed Central York taking on Hempfield. Little battle of the handshakes to start. I think Central won that, but Hempfield's going to win the tip, and Connor Moffat's going to get two right off the bat. It's always nice, but math says 3 points is better than two. Ontario Edmonds, he's one of the best from beyond the arc. And somebody give Courtney Batts a screen. There it is. Century York wins big. They'll get a rematch with Spring Grove, who smoked McCaskey 71-52. And somebody call Tom Hanks. I found Wilson. Taking on Lebanon, who upset Harrisburg in the opening round. First half, this is Logan Blouch for three. Lebanon down one, but Wilson working the break. Castaway was a really good movie. Mason McElroy and David for two. And here's the kid who almost single-handedly beat Northeastern. Christian Slode. Wilson moving on to the semis. They'll face Reading Tuesday. In college basketball, good day in PA. Penn State 70-58 over Rutgers. In Pitt, top Syracuse 66-52, Jamel Artis 21 points. It's a battle of bears. The Revenant Bear is the undisputed king, but tonight the Bruins and Hershey looking to stake their claim as Ursa Major. And speaking of Ursa Major replacing the ice, that's a bear of a task. He gets it after all that basketball. This is a themed highlight. Hershey, a stretch pass here to Sean Collins. His 12th of the year, 1-0 home team. Second period, Riley Barber going to finish off the prey. And Hershey not afraid to play Providence. They've done it already. Rematch tomorrow at 5. 3-2 the final tonight. And did Alex Ovechkin score? The answer is probably yes. This is Devils and Capitals. Here it is, goal number 38. Best in the league. From a guy who scores to one who doesn't. Usually, Brooks Orpik, former Penguin, one goal this season. Make it two. Caps first team to 90 points. 4-3 the final. No Claude Giroux for the Flyers. Steve Mason leaving the game here in the third. Flyers going to rally down 4-3. Matt Reed eyes the game. And hey, guess what? We're going to go to overtime. NHL high, 22nd time for the Flyers. Who are you going to call? Shane Gostisbehere extends his point streak to 15 games. This is historic. He's the first defenseman since Chris Chelios to do that, and he's a rookie. Flyers win 5-4. Stay with us. We'll be right back.